Hello everybody, it's Licky Giraffe here for part two of my Dark Souls playthrough. So, let's get back into it. Okay, so, I think I only played for a small bit the last time, and that was, well, I defeated the undead, like the demon. So that was all good. And now, actually, I got some souls. I should probably go level up with my souls. Oh, I can't level up here. Okay. Whatever. I don't care. Right. Place is totally wrecked. I love the terrain destruction as well with the Asylum Demon fight. Because it gives such like a great sense of power, you know, cause it smashes the pillars and bits are flying everywhere. So kill the demon and I unlock the door. Super. Now we have left the asylum. Good job. Okay. If I can remember, I think. Oh, there's still hair. Haha. Yes. look at that landscape shot. So pretty. And over there is that bird thing, but I'm not going to bother going over there yet. I need to talk about that for a while. Trade things into it to get stuff. So, God, where will we go? We've reached a dead end.
Only in the ancient legends it is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen. To leave the undead asylum in pilgrimage to the land of the ancient lords. Lordran.
So, we have arrived in Lordran. And based on that cutscene, we are the chosen undead that has left the undead asylum, has gone on a pilgrimage. I think this area is one of my favorite areas in any game. Even just the start of Dark Souls, like it just drops you in. You're in this world. Jesus. Okay, there we go. Middle of this world, and you have no idea like where you are. It doesn't tell you anything. It's just it's just wonderful. Okay, so we're gonna level up. What will I do? I will probably stick some points into strength. Because I need to up my strength, because I plan on equipping a two-handed weapon, like the claymore or maybe the Zyhander. I have not decided yet. Let's go over and talk to this guy.
Well, what do we have here? You must be a new arrival. Let me guess, Fate of the Undead. Right? Well, you're not the first. But there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the undead asylum. But too late now. Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are, actually, two bells of awakening. One's up above in the undead church. The other is far, far below, in the ruins at the base of Blight. Ring them both, and something happens. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on, but I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land of the undead?
there again, kind of keeping in the theme of it, telling you everything you really need to know. And I love the way that in Dark Souls, you know, it doesn't give you like a marker to go run over to and do this or do that. It just tells you. It tells you, almost like Morrowind-esque, what you have to do, and it's up to you to figure it out. So we know that there's a bell up the very top, and looking around, this castle here looks pretty imposing. And then like deep down below in Blighttown, but we have our quest. We need to ring the two bells. Easy peasy.
Your face.
See what else he has to say.
The cliff hollow. I don't know. Going hollow could solve quite a bit.
hollow. Let's keep talking to him.
What? Well, there are a few ways to go about it. Collect it bit by bit from corpses. Or you can butter up a cleric and get yourself summoned. And the quickest way, although I never do it, is to kill a healthy undead. Coveting thy neighbor is a...
Let's see, is there anything else to say?
Don't trouble.
No, he does not. Okay. So, right. Let's go. This corpse here. Ooh, got some humanity. Let me think, will I make myself human? I'll have to think about it while I do a little bit more exploring. Response, she cannot speak. So we reinforce Esther Flask. I won't go down that way quite yet. Run over here and I'll talk to these guys.
Hello there. I am Petrus of Thurland.
Thurland.
If not, I'd prefer...
Don't have much to talk to him about anyway. Right, now, I'm going to... Actually, is the lift even working? I don't think it is. Perfect. Oh dear, what have I done? Ah, okay. Everything is all right. Got the right word. Okay. Let's see, so, will I run through and try to get the Zyhander now? Yes, I will. Because I only have 65 souls, so if I die, it's not a very big deal at all. So I think hopefully I can remember exactly where it is. Let's just start running. Figure it out as we go along. Let's see, I'm pretty sure it's up here. That's the wind spear. Stay away from that guy. There it is, Zyhander. Okay. Let's get out of here. Before I wake up literally everybody in here. Ooh, let's try to get this soul too. I'm gonna try to be a little bit greedy. See if it pays off. Oh dear. I'm stopped. I'm gonna die. I'm upside dead. Extremely dead. But I got everything. And that's the important part. Aha, okay, I'll go collect my soul and then it is off to the Undead Burg. Soul's over there. Oh, that's okay. Just roll down. Grab my power and continue to run away. soul over there. Okay, keep running, keep running, keep running. Run, run, run. A bit of a rest. Okay, let me see. Can I even equip the Zyhander, actually? This would be cool if I could. That's fine. No problemo. I kind of like the longsword anyway, you know. Good and dependable. Okay, so... This bit right here. I really like this bit. Because it kind of... So, like, you're able to see. There's a whole bunch of enemies. If you dive in, which a lot of people probably do first of all, you just get blown to pieces. Because, like, that guy is throwing bombs. And like the enemies are fast and pretty strong, and it does a really good job of teaching you kind of the skills you need to do well in the game. You know, be careful, look ahead, try to assess the situation before diving in, try to take on enemies one by one. You know, really, really useful. Really useful skills that are going to like apply. Ah, that's the last note. That are going to apply like throughout like the game. It's done at the very start, you know, so there's no kind of mindlessly bashing your head against the wall. It starts off. Here's a really good example of how to play this game. And it's just great. I love it. Die, you fiendish foe. Slice him up good. And then I won't pop down there quite yet. Okay. Pick up the soul. And as well, actually very early on, actually I think at the very, very start, you're shown that, like, you know, pickable items are those kind of like the bright white, like weird light looking things. You know, so it's really easy to see, can I pick this up, can I not pick this up, or oh look, there's an item. And you can see them from very far away as well. The draw distance on the items is very high. So even from far away you can see, ooh, what's that skeleton over there, you know, or like what's that guy over there with it? Like what kind of loot does he have? And it really helps to drive exploration. So, there's another guy actually. Oh, and there's one down there as well. So again, you know, kind of it's like seeding opportunities for you to explore and try to figure out, like, how can I get to these? So I'm gonna slay this guy first, just to make sure he doesn't chase me. Those darn bombs, they're so annoying. So you come in chasing him, don't check the doorway to your left, and this guy comes in and ruins your day. So again, it reinforces the idea, you know, be aware of your surroundings. Check before you dive in. I'm going to hold off going through that yet. I'm going to drop down here instead. Pillage that soul. As well, if you look down here, you can see these guys just hanging there. Is there anything back here? No. So, yeah, this definitely isn't going to be like an optimal run through of Dark Souls. One reason is that I cannot remember the exact route, you know, routes and such, and plus I kind of, you know, I have a bit of a romp. I don't want to kind of talk about the game at the same time. So, if you're looking for a quick speed through where I do everything, hopefully, first time, look somewhere else. This will not be that kind of playthrough. It'll be more like a slow-paced romp, where we kind of really kind of take stock and appreciate the game for what it is, what it's trying to do, and what it teaches you, or at least what it's trying to teach you. slain those guys again because I noticed them earlier. Actually, how are you getting there? You don't like rush in and get your head blown off. Grab this guy. Sweet humanity. So many souls. So actually, there was a guy hanging down there. I'm just curious. I feel like I might have missed an opportunity to go in there. Ah, here we are. Yes. So again, I didn't see that entrance, but I did see this guy with his bright, white, glowy thing. And now, well, I can't go through there, but this facilitated exploration of the game. It's wonderful because it's entirely optional, you know, there's no benefit in-game to doing this little bit. Absolutely none. The only thing you get out of it is, you know, the sate your desire for exploration, pick up those you know, souls of the lost undead or whatever, and take your time. You know, the game doesn't rush you. I definitely think Undead Burg is probably one of my favorite parts of the entire game. I just think it's done so very, very well. Oh, another one. I've tried to jump across there many times. I've never actually managed to do it, so I don't know what's over there, and I'm not going to waste your time trying over and over again, so I'm just going to leave it. So, again, look at that. Oof. Comes across out of the blue. You know, it's like, be careful again, iterating, watch where you step. You know, you could have very easily got squashed by a dragon there. Again, you know, this guy suddenly bursts through, you've got an archer firing at you. Suddenly you've got a whole bunch of elements to deal with. But again, if you try and use what they've been trying to teach you, take enemies one at a time, take it slow, retreat if necessary, then it's okay. And you can defeat them. Damn archer, I hate him so much. Ha. Okay. This, I don't think in here. Oh, there is another one. A wooden shield. Let's check. Is that better than my awesome heater shield? Better magic and really good lightning, but not as much physical, and at the moment we're dealing with all physical, so I'm gonna stick with that. Okay, so now we have these guys. I'm trying to remember, how do you kick again? Do not remember. I think that's. I don't know. Oh well. I guess we'll just. So now kind of let them into that lair, which of course is terrible because you need like a wide open area to circle around them. So I just need to slowly wait for them to come towards me again. Come on. If I turn my back to them, they will approach faster. Oh, geez, now they're stuck in each other. Sweet mercy. Oof, dangerous. I almost find half the trick with these guys is actually just getting them to attack in the first place. It's such a pain. But again, they do provide another great lesson. You know, so they have a shield. Like the first enemies we've seen with a shield. And if you try to attack them, bang, you lose a little bit of stamina, and they have a very, very powerful strike. But they're quite slow. So again, important lesson. The enemy is a shield. Now, just don't swing mindlessly, like you're having to say possibly for the other enemies. You need to, you know, stop, think, strategize to how you're going to actually attack them, and then move on. Again, another very important lesson. Then, look at this guy. He's trying to catch us unawares, but he has not succeeded in this attempt. 2 seconds. I want to check something. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. All right, let's go talk to this guy.
Well, now you seem to have your wits about you. Then you are trade for sale.
For sale. Let's see. Do I actually talk to
things are getting treacherous in these parts. A horrible goat demon has moved in below, and up above there's that humongous drake and a bull demon too. If you stick around this place, it might end up being your grave.
So there he's mentioning the drake that we saw was big. He's mentioning like a bull demon.
Yeah, I'm not here to chit chat. We talk.
Okay, let's see. What does he sell again? Firebomb, talisman. Excuse me. Residence key. I might buy the residence key actually, because open residence is an undead burg. Trying to think if it's useful or not. I can't remember actually. I'm gonna leave it for now. If needs be, I'll just come back and buy it. Do. Again, a bunch of guys run towards us. And if you're not careful, these guys will kill you. Even though they look really weak, they have strong attacks. So I think it's the epitome of Dark Souls. You know, these guys look weak. No way can they stand it like up to you. But if you underestimate them, if they get behind you, or if they swarm you, they will take you down so quickly. And I think it's a great humbling experience. You know, again, another important lesson. Every enemy in Dark Souls can kill you if you don't pay attention. I wonder, I could probably reach it from here, actually. Might try that, then. Let's try that. Okay. Geronimo! Ah! Just falls short. Darn. Ah, well. I'm not going to bother try again. There surely can't be anything too crazy. Okay, so now I'm going to clear over that area, that's fine. I'm gonna run up here, and then, not that way quite yet, I'm gonna pop in here. Nice, enjoyable bonfire. Which I'm going to rest at. Level up, actually, what I wanna check is how much strength do I need to use the Zyhander. 24 strength, Craigie. Grant. Okay, so we'll do that, and then we need 800, so I might ingest soul. Or a soul of a lost undead. Perfect, okay. This area can be pretty dangerous, and I would hate to lose souls at this early stage. So we'll buff up our strength. I wanna get the required strength first. Actually, I might put some more actually into health as well. Oh, haha! Easy souls. That's another thing I love actually, is that like if you just run off, you will fall off. It's very easy to fall off, and that the enemies can also fall off, you know, like there's not like a magical barrier holding them there. Which is wonderful. You know, there are videos on Dark Souls of, like, bosses who just, like, make a misstep and just fall off the side, and that's it. Yeah, you win. I remember the first time I played this game, I was stuck on this area, like, this little bit for so long. I couldn't do it. Just level from this side, it's fine. Down fire throwers. Anything interesting in here? Check out. No. Poor show by me. I was impatient. Ah, a chest. Black firebomb. Handy. Guys here now. Slay him. Haha. Alright, let's go up. Let's go up here and slay these fire bombers. I hate them so very much. Take that. And this. Some of that, haha! Again, another, just glorious, glorious landscapes. You see a wall at the very top of there. I think that might be Anorlanda. I just love running around this world. It feels so, not real, but just so well put together. It's an absolute joy. Interesting in here. I do not think so. Oh, wait, no. Oh, here we are. Boom. Gold pine resin. I'm sure that energizes your weapon with the power of lightning, which will potentially be very useful. Titanite shard, alright. Damn spear dudes. Oh, got me good there. Let's go up here. Love. I absolutely love this guy. So where did I get those souls from? Ah, oh, yeah, I think he might have killed himself. By accident. And let's see, there is a black knight down here, and I'm just curious as to whether or not I want to fight him. What I might do is I might use some of that gold pine resin. I think the black knights are weak to gold pine resin. Actually, we'll try it once. We'll try it once without any resin, and we'll see. Okay, seen us. Let's get back to a more open area, so that we may do battle. I always bring him back here, usually. Okay. I love the what's it called? The look of the knights. They look so, so cool. Ha, backstab. Take that. So again, slow, calculated. Really kind of like about looking at his moveset. He's not particularly aggressive, but he hits hard. So you know, learn his moveset, know like when he's finished like attacking. So you can go in, get a strike in. Like if he hits you, like it will hurt. Like he hits hard. Especially because like at this level, like we're still pretty weak. But just keep circling around him, keep stabbing at him. Kind of abuse the fact that he is so slow. Because he's low health, you know, don't take risks. Risks get you killed. It's important to take it slow. Remember, so many times, you know, like a knight or a boss has been on low health, and you go like, oh, I can make like this one more swing to like finish him off now, and you miss or you do something stupid. And it's even just there, I did it. And you try to go for the kill, and it doesn't work out, and the boss kills you, and you want to throw the controller through the damn screen, and there you go. Titanite chunk. Wonderful. Now I'm gonna get that key. Let me think now. Actually, what's the time? And I do need to go now, actually, unfortunately. So I won't be able to run up and do the boss. So I'm gonna have to, unfortunately, do all of this again in my next video. Though, actually, what I might do is I might just get up to this point and then start the video so you guys don't have to watch me do all of it again. Let's see, actually, yeah, that's what I might do. Actually, is there anything back here? There is not. And also, my 2200 souls, I do not want to lose them. So yeah, I might just run back, take a safe bonfire, finish the video, and then get back over to that point for the next video, and then you guys, we can carry on from there. I attempt my first boss. So even now that I've played this game a few times, I still sometimes have a bit of trouble with him. Okay, cool. I'll rest here. Thanks as always for watching, guys, and I look forward to putting up part 3. Have a good day. If I can find the stop recording button. Ah, here it is.